Disney is awesome. Video games are awesome. Disney video games are... they're just kind of hit or miss. I'm sure every gamer has owned at least one video game based after a movie. Heck, we've been getting them just about for as long as the video game industry itself has existed. And let's be honest, most of us gamers had zero monies when we were younger, so sometimes those discount Disney games were pretty tasty looking. Sometimes we get a unique, fun experience that captures the essence of the film it's based after, like GoldenEye 007. And sometimes you get a phoned-in copy and paste of Superman 64, like that stinking Finding Nemo nightmare. Now, to be fair, we can't really blame the game developers for that. Normally, the games themselves are just made to cash in on the popularity of the movie they're based after and need to meet a strict deadline, plus are released on pretty much every video game console ever. Seriously, do you know how hard it would be to make the same game for Xbox 360 and Game Boy Advanced? So not much effort goes into them. As a result, most games based after popular movies are normally not very good, with a few exceptions like Star Wars and... more Star Wars. This really stinks, because most movies would make great games with their creative universes and characters. Thankfully, sometimes all you need for a game to be enjoyable is creative universe characters and a whole bunch of nostalgia. And there are few companies who have more nostalgia than Disney.
And Sega.
Okay, we're not talking about Sega right now.
I'm just saying, Sega characters are pretty great. Please like me.
This studio has been the most notorious, successful, consistent, and loved movie maker for as long as they've been around. Everyone I've ever met grew up with one Disney movie or another, and even if you're not a big fan of everything they do, you've gotta admit there's at least one film that spoke to you. They've had some good and some not-so-good films, but almost all of them have a unique style and really likable characters. In turn, the nostalgia and love that I have for some Disney movies carries over to the games based on them. I actually grew up with some of the games, since they were really all I could afford. I found most of them for 1 cent on Amazon, so today we're taking a trip through just a few Disney movie game installment things. Stuffs.
Welcome to Peter Kunetter Unboxing and Minecraft videos. Look at that. It's pretty good.
That's pretty good!
Oh man. The memories with these guys. I never actually played this one. Gosh, this game looks horrifying. Put those right there. Ooh. How about that? How about those skills right there, eh? I should make katana videos.
Let's kick things off with some torture, why don't we? Finding Nemo, the video game. This right here is a classic example of what many of us in the gaming industry call a load of shish. Fish shish. This game is notoriously bland, bad, and more bad, so of course we're going to subject ourselves to it.
Watch out! Watch out!
What the heck?
Woo! Woo-hoo! Whoa! This is gnarly fun, man.
And keep trying to swim through all the rings!
Woo-hoo! Yeah! Ooh, rings! Bubble rings! Underwater rings made of bubbles underwater.
Hey, guys! Look what I found in the cave!
Poop? You just pooped.
Thanks for saving me.
Look what I found in the cave. I found my own poop.
Oh, what is this? Woo! More rings! Woo!
That was fun. I love how diverse this level is from the rest of the game. We're doing this backwards. How? How? Why? Why am I questioning this? More rings to fly through. Woo!
Nemo, be careful of those clams!
Oh, the clams, Nemo! Watch out for the clams! Oh, they're clammy! Oh my gosh! Where the flip am I going?
Finding Nemo, the video game. For when you just want to play a game that says you don't want to play this game. Now let's get into the excitement of this video, watching me relive nostalgic childhood experiences that you won't feel nostalgia for because you really didn't experience them with me. Yay! This game I definitely put the most hours into of all the games that we're looking at in this video, and it is Walle.
Okay, this. This game is the shiz, or the shish, as many of you like to say. This was literally, as a kid, probably my favorite game. 200 megabits of RAM. I'd have to upgrade the old PC here.
Don't have enough dedicated WAM.
Not enough dedicated WAM.
Dedicated WAM, I should have to a server.
Oh, look at these. You get the little figures. You ever want a toy of a fat guy sitting in a chair? Walle, that's for you. Also, he just got stabbed by like some kind of pike. That's not good.
This was one of my favorite movies as a kid, and I still find the first half that takes place on the post-apocalyptic Earth to be one of the best things that Disney has done. The atmosphere of this world is really well presented, and for me, the video game was the same way. There are a lot of missions on the ground that feel very alone, and it makes you feel like this is a good companion for the movie. Now, I've done you all a favor by only showing you gameplay from after I played this game for myself for a little while. Most of the first few missions that I recorded consisted of
nostalgia,
much childhood,
I feel young again,
I miss you early 2000s PC game,
nostalgia,
I remember this,
I have to pee.
So yeah, I'll just let you watch from the point where I got over my nostalgia crisis. You're welcome.
Your cardboard mom.
Another Walle unit is still on top of the tower. Go inside the building and find a way to access the upper floors.
Gotta collect them fuses, just like in the movie. You remember that whole scene in Walle where he's gotta collect all the fuses? Where he's gotta save the Empire from the rebels by collecting all the fuses?
Oh yeah, I know, bruh.
Ah, there we go. Hey, a plunger. Artifact collected. So it's an ancient plunger with ancient human feces on it. Which is now ancient human feces on Walle's face. Oh, I remember these things.
Oh, yeah.
The world is a place full of cubes. Some cubes go boom.
Those ones were the best.
Cube. Cube. I'm collecting ones I already made to try and throw at this box.
You could just laser it, too.
No, I have to do it this way. This way is the cool way. I can't do it while I'm... Boom. Are you kidding me? There, are you happy?
Yes.
Oh my gosh! What the heck was that? I always say not to look down, but that's all I can look at.
And that's why you fall. Because you're looking down instead of forward.
Don't say that I fall, because then I will fall. You're gonna jinx it. And when it gets... Jinxed! You jinxed it! With any large moment in a video game, there comes a choice. Make friends with the Walle, or push him off to his death.
Which would be pretty pointless considering that you're already alone. So.
That's karma.
Ha!
Ah, I missed. Okay, we definitely didn't do that. We're here to be your friend, buddy. Oh, we killed him after all. Well, you know what he said is because we just wasted like 20 minutes doing this and got nowhere. So 6 years later, after playing this game a ton as a child, I love this game just as much. Nostalgia aside, this is one of the few Disney games that is actually genuinely fun and free. And there's so much to do that I actually recommend this game to those of you who might be on a really tight budget. Also, once you get into the further levels, this game gets really creepy as you have to sneak around the Axiom in space. But it's not nearly as creepy as sneaking around in this next game.
Rat, a Tui. The only film where they actually put the pronunciation of the title in the title. I remember in the trailers for Ratatouille, they had, like, every single trailer that I can remember, they would have the characters repeat the name Ratatouille over and over and over to hammer it into your head how it's pronounced, so people didn't mispronounce it. One thing I will say, this game has a full-color manual. You don't see that very much. Even Sega normally had black and white.
So we got some nice plushies here.
Beautiful.
Creepy rat chef with demonic eyes and a yo-yo, maybe?
Also a two-disc set. In beautiful condition.
Or is it a three-disc set?
Is it?
I don't know. Is it?
No. Why would you say that?
Up next, the game that gave me nightmares for weeks when I first played it, Ratatouille. To be honest, this movie wasn't really for me. I know a lot of people liked it, but I was mostly pretty bored with the whole thing. I guess as a kid, I wasn't much for the slower-paced, less action-packed Disney film. The game, however, is horrifying. It mostly consists of completing objectives and collecting items for other rats. The difficulty in this is avoiding the humans. Now, I get really antsy and stressed when you have to avoid being spotted in any video game. And to be honest, all you really have to do when you're seen is press some buttons really fast, like a QuickTime event, but the people, they're horrifying. I've never seen anything so scary in video games since Big the Cat. Or Finding Nemo. Something about their poorly rendered faces makes you fear them, not as a threat, but as a visual torture. A nightmare-inducing visual torture.
No. Oh my gosh. It's horrifying. With its giant lollipop that looks more like a pancake and its stinking hat. Okay, run away, run away. Oh gosh. Move. Stupid flower! Oh my gosh. I see you have an evil twin. One of these days, you'll all pay for the horrifying memories you've given me. Ow. Alright, note to self. Human feet stink so much they kill you, apparently. For years I've put up with these people. All the years I've played this game, I've put my fears and horrors aside to get past the game, to get you stupid rat over here, your stinking fuses or whatever the crud it is you need. I say it's time for revenge. We're gonna kill them all with this spoon. I mean, in the movie, there was that guy. Didn't he kill a guy with his thumb? I'm pretty sure that was that movie. I don't know for sure. Now we'll kill the stupid kid. Come here, you stupid kid. Ow. Okay. He's very good at using counterattacks. Well, I certainly don't know what to... Oh. Okay, we can just spend the rest of our time doing this. You know what? Humans can do whatever they want. As long as I can do this, this is a lot of fun.
This game is very similar to Walle in the sense that you don't really have to follow a direct path as most Disney games. It's pretty fun, frantic, easy to control, not too bad overall. Next up is Cars. Now, before we get into it, sit back for a moment. I'm going to tell you a little story about a child named Peter. Peter was a weird, wimpy kid. That has nothing to do with the story, but anyway, all he had was an old PC, despite his love for video games. And so when the new hit movie Cars came out, which he was definitely totally obsessed with at the time, he just had to play the new racing game that accompanied it. He tried saving up money, and eventually kind of convinced his parents to buy it for him. And it wasn't long until he finally had his chance to purchase what would become his new obsession. So he went out, bought the game, brought it home, put it in his old Windows 95 PC, and found out that he accidentally got the lame minigame Cars video game instead of the action racing one. He really wanted the racing one, but overall didn't care too much. He didn't have very high standards at that time. So yeah, believe it or not, the guy in the story was me. I made the mistake of getting the wrong game, but I still always wanted that racing Cars game, and now, after years, I'm finally getting it. So anyway, let's check out what younger Peter missed out on.
Your computer just isn't as advanced enough like mine.
Okay, so it never worked. The dream still hasn't exactly come true. I'm still kind of working on that. I played a demo for it a few years ago, and I mean, it was okay. Moving on. Okay, only two games left, and this next one doesn't have any childhood tragedies or nostalgia mixed in. You know, Disney has a lot of movies that I honestly don't care for. Sure, I like a few, like The Incredibles and Inside Out, which I really felt spoke to me on a personal level, but I'll admit, I'm not really a Disney fan. I wasn't a fan of, like, Lion King or Monsters, Inc., which kind of came out when I was growing up, even though most people just adore those ones. I never really got it. Just in general, I've never been one to like all the movies that Disney puts out, and that most people see as classic masterpieces. Oh, and I can't stand Disney Channel. I'm sorry, I can't, and that's a topic for another video. I'll explain then.
Miska! Muska! Miska! Muska! Miska! Muska!
That being said, I actually have a few not as good or popular Disney movies that I really liked, even though most people didn't care for them. I don't know, I'm kind of weird. An example of this would be the movie Bolt. I saw this movie when it came out and completely forgot about it, as most people did. I mean, they don't think it's a bad movie, but it's generally just seen as kind of... well, it's there. Not a really great, fantastic work of art by Disney. Just last month, I decided to check it out again, as I really didn't remember it, but it looked kind of interesting. And I actually really loved it. Sure, the story of some pets trying to get home to their owners is cliche as heck, but besides the story, I loved everything about this film.
The animation, the setting of a dog who thinks he's a superhero is actually pretty interesting. The characters especially. I think they were probably the best part of this film overall. I may have to talk about this film and others mentioned in this video in the future, so I don't waste too much time here. But anyway, I'll get to the point. The point is, I just bought the Bolt game because it looked fun, and I didn't grow up with it, but I kinda like the movie a lot, so that's the next one.
This is the only game that didn't cost 1 cent. Bolt, the video game. Save $1 on batteries today. In theaters, 11/26/08. So this is one of those games that came out before the actual movie, which is...
Yeah, these pictures, look up close at that. Scooter, not in-game. They had to specify that the scooter is not actually featured in the game. Just because, you know, very deceiving. Dude, this is like TVception. We're watching a TV on our TV. 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 On our TV.
That's a weird place to put a piano.
Oh, yay, we get to be Miley Cyrus! Oh, we got a power upgrade. Our power is now over 9,000. Oh my gosh! We're like ninjas.
Hold that in X for a sneak.
360 no scope!
Oh, you tricked him!
That was weird. Hey, we got him! Victory dance! It's like using a homing attack in Sonic, actually.
Yeah. Okay, grab them and try to throw them.
Ooh.
Here's my dad.
That's a weird place to put a piano.
You're going Super Saiyan!
Oh my god! What's up, fishes? Oh! You can actually use that against him.
Oh, run from the chopper!
Super
my gosh, run from the chopper!
So this game is actually pretty cool. You know that Spyro reboot that I can't stand? The gameplay is a lot like that one, except since it's not taking a series that I loved and completely changing it into something that's not really quite as good, I don't mind it. It's a beat-em-up that gives you meter-filling thingies when you get kills, and has a lot of quick-time segments mixed in with the combat, so pretty much exactly like The Legend of Spyro. Overall, not too shabby, and the fact that it's not really based after the plot of the movie Bolt, but rather the part of the movie that has him as an action hero, fits really well with a video game. Alright, we have one game left, and if you thought this video's thumbnail just had Zootopia in it for views, you are half right. But seriously, the next game is Zootopia. It's a find-and-click mobile game. Yay. Enter your age. Yes. Invalid age, hey! That's pretty racist against people who are 900. Try picking up the book, yeah. Hey, you got points. Now I know why it's so fun to be a police officer. You get so many points for just picking up books. Okay, are we done? Can we just get on to the next one? It's probably going to be pretty difficult to analyze this piece of fabric. Yep, that was pretty hard. I'm glad we have the skills. We have this guy, or girl, I can't really tell, who apparently has a PhD in, I don't know, analyzing. It's like looking up at some kind of dead relative floating above him in the sky.
All around me are familiar faces.
I don't want to be a police officer anymore. Not if they have to deal with these stinking load times. Jeez. Profile. Height. Hunched over. Ah, yes. That's a very specific height. I remember when I was like 13. See, I was a little tall for my age, so I was like a size 4 hunched over. I think my dad was probably like 6 hunched over at that point. Like maybe 6 and a half hunches over. 5 pounds plus tracking chip? What does that even mean? Also, did people in Zootopia eat fish? Because, I mean, technically those would be animals. I don't know, maybe it's like Finding Nemo or something. Other. Whacked out. Yeah, that's definitely an important feature. I shall accuse this guy because of the clues that we have found, and that any person who plays this game that is over the age of, I don't know, a half a year would probably understand. All right, cool. Put him in the electric chair. Want to hear something that you've never heard before? I really loved Zootopia. Yeah, that's pretty crazy, but you don't hear that very much. But the game that we're looking at, the only Zootopia game, is a point-and-click investigation game. That's just about the least effort you can put into a game to cash in on the movie. Now, despite that, I will say that at least you play the role of a detective, so it does have something to do with the movie, which is a lot more than I can say for Frozen Freefall, which is just Bejeweled with nothing. It's just Bejeweled.
So, overall, what can we say about Disney games? Most of the time, they're pretty rushed, they're mostly just cash-ins, they're almost always very unoriginal, and I have always had fun with them.
Nostalgia goes a long way with me. Like I said before, I'm no Disney fan, and I don't really care for most of the things that they do, but when they make a movie that sits just right with me, it has a huge impact. Movies like The Incredibles and Walle were my childhood, and I still love them today. And new movies like Zootopia, or movies that I'm just now getting to watch, like Bolt, have quickly become some of my favorite media experiences. Because of that, it's kinda hard to make a game of these films that I dislike, because they become a part of the movie experiences. Sure, the gameplay can be tacky or unoriginal, but the nostalgia and love that I have for the movies, new or old, makes the experience worthwhile. Besides with the Finding Nemo game, there's...
Watch out!
Would I suggest the games that we played in this video to anyone else? It's kinda hard to say yes. I'm not sure I would play some of the games that I grew up with nowadays, but as a kid who was enthralled and charmed by these films when they came out, it was more than worth my time. So in that sense, yeah, if you love a certain movie enough to the point where you want to live out the experiences in a more interactive form of media, these games can be a lot of fun. They're not always going to be great, but when you go into them with the nostalgia and memories that the film gave you, playing these games can be a great way of improving your experience of the movie as a whole. I can look back at my memories of Walle and Cars and recall the films and the games as part of one experience. Different medias about one universe, one set of characters, one story, making a great experience as a whole. Sometimes that's all you need to enjoy a game, and make your favorite memories that much bigger.
So those are my thoughts on Disney games. I actually had a lot of fun playing...
You gotta go fast.
Why did you interrupt me to say that?
No, I just have to make sure that all your subscribers who are Sonic fans don't get too bored because you're talking about a non-Sonic topic.
Can't say that makes a whole lot of sense, but okay.
You know, on the topic of movies, reviewing the Sonic movie would be a great way to keep those subs happy. And keep me happy.
True, it would make a lot of sense for that to be the next video, but I kinda already reviewed that.
But you said you wouldn't your last video.
I had forgotten when I was making that video, and to be fair, I was watching a lot of really cruddy cartoons. You gotta cut me some slack in remembering things.
Well, you could forget again.
Not sure that's how it works.
Well, what if I ask one of my cardboard friends to sneak up behind you and whack you in the back of the head with a shovel, causing you to forget everything?
What? There's no one there.
Ha, don't be silly, I don't have any friends.
Ah.
That's a weird place to put a piano.
Stay tuned to this channel for an upcoming review of the Sonic the Hedgehog original video animation movie. Wow, that's a handful. Coming soon. Also, thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out DJ BassFox28, who made this fantastic music that you're listening to now. You can find him in the description of this video along with my Twitter, where you can get updates on upcoming videos. Thanks a ton for watching, and have yourselves a wonderful day.
Watch out!